Genau. Watch out! Yeah. Thank you. will have 5 minutes of additional time though, so perhaps time for a chance or two more. Always wonder if that passes into the players' minds. You get those situations of a few more minutes than expected to give you a little reset, a little mental, physical reset, maybe having mentally prepared for 1 or 2 minutes and a case of keeping things as they are to head down the tunnel, unless of course you're behind. Shiri. That's what failed to bring it out that time. And bit of miscontrol lets them off. Kurubechi picking it up to her own hand. Medaliua won the Champions League, Women's Champions League. First attempt last year. Again, Tolokelli, and it wasn't far away from a strike partner. Cut inside was nice from Shebak. This does not look good for Fatima Tagnaut. She won't want her semi-final appearance, potentially her tournament, to end like this. On the left knee again, but clearly already an issue. Can certainly say she's not playing at 100% fitness here. Looked lively enough in the early minutes, but then that knock clearly aggravating an already existing problem. She'll be on the sidelines for now and rounds with an extra player for the final 90 seconds, perhaps. All the way through to Emishi, though. One of Tagnaut's main assets is her speed. Acceleration, so quick off the mark. Of course, speed with the ball at her feet. She's back on, but certainly moving gingerly here. Comparisons occasionally made to Lionel Messi in the men's game and her style of play. Of course, that wand of a left foot. Without that burst of acceleration, it's getting trickier to operate at the very best. Clearly hobbling. She's looking forward to the half-time break, I assume, and full 15 minutes treated by the medics, but will they be one down by the time they go down the tunnel? It's into the middle, and the ball just wide. Niels Rabali in the middle, picked out by Lebohang Ramalepe. kicks down the right wing. Nicked away once again from Aziza Rabah. Just not quite getting a foot through it. Orjumela Rabale. Frustration there. And it is the final action of the half. Nothing to separate the two. The game remains very much in the balance. Heading into the second 45. Nil-nil, not for the lack of trying, these two sides. Just coming up against an equally well-drilled defence. Front of both goals. About 45 minutes. Further to find out. Heading to the final. As the sun has gone down, the Maloney Sundowns return to the pitch to take on Aspar. Only one able to reach the final here in Kohogo. Second half of this first semi-final in the Cup Women's Champions League matches. Yet to be separated. Goalless at the halfway point. A few close calls in the last actions of the first half. It's a big chance for Boitumelu Rabale. Didn't get the connection she wanted though. So two sets of players went down the tunnel. Still with the deadlock unbroken. Ivorians still in good voice. Sadly for them, Atletico Abidjan eliminated at the group stages. Plenty of football still to enjoy. Another semi-final to come later this evening. It's over in San Pedro. We're now focusing on Mamelodi Sundowns and Aspar for 45 more minutes at least. We'll go to extra time. They still can't be separated by the final whistle. But there is the first whistle of the second half and we are back underway. Sundown shooting from right to left. The Brazilian colours, yellow, blue and white, looking for a samba start to this second half. It's a decent ball into the middle. Fans and players, technical staff, I'm sure, are all pleased to see Fatima Tagnout back out for the second half. Twirling winger, a little subdued with a knock to her knee in the first half. Went down, no one around her, and looked maybe to be a terminal issue, but happily able to carry on, adding to the class already present in this semi-final. Goal kick. It's cut out by Noahang Malepe. A good way to Olakeli. A nice through ball through for Isiwe McCoy. Shaping up to be another chance for Rabale, but the flag has gone up against McCoy. Close call, trying to hold the line, but just leaning the wrong side of Siam Bukami. Benzina with the free kick. Aspar a little on the back foot in the opening couple of minutes here, but now with an opportunity to hold on to possession for a little while. Get themselves back at their very best. It's forward to Banuk, so he took a knock or two, and is carrying on. There and a few complaints, but play continues. This ball into the middle, a little indecisive. It appeared there, Adelaide Dlamini allowed it to bounce. Ball in was from Hanan Ait El Haj. dangerously close to Banouk. Benzina laying it off into Tolakele. Chested down well by McCoy. Now they're coming together. Chambadri goes down, seemingly in pain. The referee allowing play to continue for now. Now pause proceedings to wave on the medics. Once again getting the ball, well, both getting the ball technically, and then ending up studs down on the top of the boot of a Moroccan player on the first time. I think they have all genuinely been accidents. Certainly a painful one again for Badri. One of four goal scorers on the pitch for Asfar, along with Tagnaut. Noela Benzina, less likely scorer from centre back. And of course, Safa Banouk, the number nine. So four goals in the Sundowns 11. Three of those, though, Tolakele. Ramalepe with the other. Joint top scorer, Rufilwe Tolakele, after the group stages. Another featured in the group stage, best 11. Has been ever present. Those three group games, I'm sure, with an eye. In the honour of top scorer in the golden boot. We'll have our first change of the game. Spurs number 13 ready to come on. Afia Niame. Let's see. That's an enforced change. That's a lovely ball through. And it's Tolakele who turns back, creates out some space, and just wide. Whistles past the far post. We're talking about heading to the top of the scoring charts. That would have sent her there. Some style. Beautiful ball through from Rabali, and then that turn has created the space. It looked like it was heading for the top corner. Khadija Ermici surely relieved. So whistle past the post. Good tackle. Zaspar looked to strike back immediately. Terms of a big chance, not a goal. Captain getting stuck in though, Zanelli Lapo. Another ever present along with this lady. Tolakele just slicing across it and head in hands. Knows how close that was and much closer it could have been. But it is sadly for the neutral, certainly, and I'm sure the Asfar fans. Fatim Attack now, who is forced off, gave it a go, presumably. A 15-minute break to allow that knock to heal, but too much. Sadly ends Fatim Attack now's involvement, at least in this semi-final. To wait and see if it's a longer term issue. She'll be able to continue in the next match, whether or not that is the final for the bronze medal playoff. Follow along with the hashtag CAFWCL2023. Let us know where you're watching from, who you're cheering on, what has got you off your seat so far. There will be Tolakele's effort on goal. To be to be a goal that would surely unlock this game. The current stalemate we have, no lack of class and not a lack of action. But two very good defences holding firm for now. Strong tackle, perfect example of exactly why it remains goalless after almost an hour of football. So the composure at the back playing a big part. Both sets of players comfortable playing out from the back. One was missed by Lapo, but Kurevici bailing out to captain. Slightly behind her, that's the way you improvise. Over to the substitute, Yame, with her first involvement. Another player down to Sundown's defender. It's Bravo Kurevici. Taking a stud to the arm, it would appear. Shamalala is also forced into a change, as was his opposite number, Mohamed Aliua. Aliua, another nominated for CAF Women's Coach of the Year, along with Shamalala. A young manager, Aliua. 36 years of age, despite his relatively tender years, certainly in coaching terms, he's not new to Asfar, having been part of the project since 2008 as a youth coach initially. Successes with the age grade teams catapulted him to the head coach role of the women's side in December of 2021, then led to a domestic double. And of course, his league title. Strong Sundown tackle from Tandy this time. Seemingly had herself in the process, so she let Mafia Nyame know what this game was all about. Sundown aren't afraid of a challenge. Have another break in play. Dominant force of Moroccan football, Moroccan women's football. The unstoppable Moroccans claim their 10th title and 8th in a row this year. Most literally unstoppable, undefeated, winning 24 and drawing 2 to 26 games, scoring over 100 goals, conceding just 8 in the process. And then another record extending 10th thrown cup as well to the trophy cabinet for a good matchup. Beat the fellow Women's Champions League semi finalists, Sporting Casablanca 5-0 in the final there. They are currently on top this season, but that simply due to having played fewer games than we'd had. CSS D Tamara above them. 3 wins from 3, 15 scored, and 0 conceded. Normal service will be resumed shortly, I would imagine. What a bad start. But focused on continental duties right now. Trying to find a way through this stubborn Sundowns defence. Whilst not conceding to an equally dangerous Sundowns attack. Free kick goes Sundowns' way this time. Clumsy, certainly from Zlane Chebak. Another break, some players checks over. Which gives me an opportunity to tell you about Sundowns. It's a dominant force domestically as well. A record extending 5th title, South African top flight, running away with the 2022 season, finishing 14 points clear to 27 wins in 30 games. A similar record to their opposition tonight, just the 3 in a row though for Sundowns, for a short wait following triumphs in 2013 and 15. Record of the Super Falcons, who won 3 consecutive titles between 2010 and 2012. Similarly though, in a different sense, and certainly not a lack of games played, has remained very much in the balance in the final stages of this season. Referee. come down to free kick. Shabalala being a little more vocal on the sidelines, feeling the need for attention, ramping up. Sit up temptingly, certainly, effectively laid up by Phil Rabali. Maybe more changes incoming for Asfar. Still yet to see one from Sundowns. The free kick. Still closer to goal this time. Rabali, the set-piece specialist. Five to aim at on the edge of the box. Lofted in, falls back. The strike from Tandy. It might have just taken a nick off the defender before she was able to strike it. See on the replay. Yeah, I think so. Closed down by Nyame. Importantly so. Actually surprisingly close to the target, considering took a touch off the defender just before. Fired effectively into her foot. Kelly with space and tries itself. Everyone was looking at the options in the middle except for Tolakelli, and fortunately for Asfar, Iramishi was alive to the danger at her near post. Nice ball from Rabali. Space to get inside, and then the acute angle trying to catch out the keeper, who was looking at the options in front of her. Sundowns now, the wind in their sails, pushing on. It's caught under the feet though. There, and now it's Asfar breaking away. Banuk caught by Lepe in the end, trucking back. Still down to that. Under her feet is McCoy. Lovely through ball, but just not quite the pace to outrun Abraham Ramalepe. Captain Lapo back as well. Woman in African football. She's been part of the Morocco national side since 2010. Played as her side finished runners-up in last year's WAFCON. Nations, of course. Also part of the squad for the 2023 Women's World Cup after losing to Germany in the first match. Managed to keep two clean sheets against South Korea and Colombia to help make Morocco the first Arab and North African country to reach the round of 16. A few more. But there's her cap there, that she needs any. Set to a Champions League title would be sure she does have her eye on. Coy looks set to return to the field, no change necessary.
Minutes or so from both a famous victory of
first win over Aspar. More importantly, revenge. The 2022 final. But that 15 minutes feel like an eternity. They remain just one up. Now will they fall into the trap of defending deeper? Tap often the best form of defence, but they're immediately on the defensive here. Corner for Aspar. Disappointing one in truth from captain Ghislaine Chabac. Sundowns will look to break, and the pace of Levan Ramalepe has kept that alive. Pull down, Galiente playing her part, the fresh legs. Sundowns took it quickly, gave it away, got it back though. Galiente to the goal scorer, Rabale looked to release. Tolakele returned the favour, not quite an assist for the number nine. Her corner cleared out to Rabale. Badri. Aspar. Patient still. Good tackle. Sundowns remain resilient. Shot from range. Kicked to ball for Andele Delimi. Takes something special to be heard from there. Goalkeeper of the group stages. Heading for 6 hours of 2023 Women's Champions League football without being beaten. We have this far player down, Mukami. Right, so Ziza Rabar again. Set up anyway. Slammed into the ground somewhat by Adianetti. She wants to continue though and get on with things quickly. Aspar can't afford to let these seconds tick away. Shalala. Break. It's seemingly the wrist that's taking the brunt of that impact for Abba. She's going to hold it and it'll be strapped up. She will try to carry on. That's far for now. Down to 10. Options. Frustrated at the lack of them. Zina somehow coming away with the ball, not once, not twice, but three times. Gets it back again. Just about kept in by Hernan Aydelhaj. And a committed tackle from Sundowns could launch a counter-attack. There's space on the left for Tolakele. Here she is. A couple of step-overs, maybe another attempt. They're blocked before it really left her boot. This will suit Sundowns well enough in possession. Aspar half. As long as they have the ball, Aspar can't score. And there, it goes again. Sloppy pass, and it's possession back to the Moroccan side.
Sundowns coming close.
close to cementing the win. And who else but Rafael Waitola Kelly. Good save. But first, well struck effort, but the second wasn't bad either. Laid back up to the number nine. Did indeed take a touch. Will be a corner. It's not held, but pulled up one way or another by Khadija Amishi, who's together. Sundowns player. Going, of course. Everyone evading must have been 15 or 16 players around the edge of Andrea Dlamini's area. Minutes for Asfar to try and rescue this with an equaliser. But again, Tony Moriffi is offside. Kicks the ball very gently away and escapes without a yellow card for doing so. Waiting patiently Leicester on the edge of the area in the D. All down to the delivery, which fails to beat the first wave of that yellow defence. Turn from Badri, there's a bit of space, pushes a little further into the Sundowns half, in fact for a corner. Responsibility, the delivery once again rests with Aitel Hadj. Once again though, it hits first line of defence. Right back with the bigger player set forwards. He's knocked on with a shoulder there. The Sundowns just as lively as Asfar. Getting back and chasing the ball. There's a bit of space here on the left for Ghislaine Shiri. The best first touch pushed her wide. Nonetheless, it's flicked on by Aziz Arabar, but only for a goal kick. One waiting behind her at the back post to be the hero. Tension simmering a little, maybe. Less than 2 minutes remaining. Perhaps surprisingly, for the first time, there's a Sundowns player down. See, crowd kicking in for many of the players at this stage of the game, and not in a hurry to get up if you're one goal up deep into stoppage time, understandably. That was a quick down and a quick up from the Sundowns player. And they'll settle for that any day. Another free kick, a few more seconds disappearing. Liana bundled over, a little bit of afters. Whether that was the plan or not, referee just to sort it out. The seconds are ticking down. Oh, too much to watch. Gasago picks up a yellow for her part in that. 30 seconds remain. Sent downfield from Sundowns, but that's one of their own players, even though there were four there. But then straight in, straight back. The long legs of Marifi again now, used for the defensive side of things. He's given away. And they're away here. Marifi, she's through. She can settle it, but it's a heavy touch. They could have absolutely cemented the result, but it won't matter because that is the final whistle. And Sundowns are heading to the Women's Champions League final. The 2021 winners see off the 2022 winners. The reigning champions are out. The holders will only fight for bronze. And it's Sundowns who will look to fight to reclaim their trophy. They won the inaugural title. Now they'll look to win the third. Asfar fought valiantly throughout. But a moment of class from Sundowns, and in particular, Oitumelu Rabale with the composure to find the net. What's the difference? Come the final whistle. Polar opposite emotions on the pitch. Celebrations, commiserations. Here, the winning moment. Bravery, the two number 10s battling for the ball. But it wasn't Najat Badri, it was Oitumelu Rabale.
Congratulations, champion. So, this is it. You are in final. How do you feel?
First of all, I would like to thank Almighty God for making it possible today. And I want to thank my coach, Coach Jerry, and the technical team, my teammates. It's a teamwork.
Who do you want for opponent? Casablanca or Dakawa?
I can't choose that one. Any team, I'm ready.
Okay, so congratulations again and good luck.
Thank you.
Any team, they are ready. They've beaten the holders. They won't mind whether it's Sporting Casablanca or Ampam Dakoa who await them in the final.
Messi!
They'll feel they can
Messi!
Beat anyone.
Messi!
Refilwe Tolakele was excellent again.
Messi!
Didn't get the goal she perhaps deserved. She played her part in the only goal of the game, though. Taking the corner that fell to Boitumelo Rabali. Adelaide Lamini did her part as well. Not called upon too often, perhaps. Not as often as she would have expected against Aspar. But she remains unbeaten in this tournament. Aspar extended the difference in possession between the two, 56-44% by the final whistle. But the attempts tell a different tale. Sundowns was 17 to Aspar's 7.